What is up, you guys? It's Jensen. Clearly, I'm back with another video. So, a lot of you guys have been asking me to do more of drugstore type videos because I feel like I do a lot of higher end makeup videos. So, today I went to Walmart and picked up quite a few products. And I also already have quite a few drugstore products, and I'm just going to do a full face of drugstore makeup because not everybody has $1 billion to go freaking spend on this expensive makeup. So I'm gonna show you guys really good drugstore makeup. I'm also gonna be first impressioning, is that even a word? I don't know, I just made it one. Some drugstore products that I haven't even used myself. So we're gonna test those out as well. So if you guys want to see everything that I'm about to get into, keep on watching. Okay, so a lot of this makeup I've heard Tati talk about. That's why I got a lot of these products. So we're just gonna test things out. I'm gonna go over the stuff that I got from Walmart, and then I'll show you stuff that I already have like around in my vanity. So the first two things that I picked up were two new foundations. Hopefully they match me pretty decent, but I have the Flower Light Illusion Luminous Makeup Nude Skin Fill All Day Wear Foundation. I've heard a lot of good things about this. I do have oily skin, so I am gonna test that out because Tati reviewed this and said it is a very luminous foundation. But if you know me, I still like really luminous, glowy foundation. So we're gonna test that. And then probably in a different video, I'm going to test out the e.l.f. one because I've heard a lot of people talking about this as well, and it's super affordable. I'm gonna leave all the prices on the screen somewhere for you guys. Also, we'll have all the products linked below like always. But yes, I haven't tried either of these foundations, so I'm very excited, but I am gonna use the flower one today because I have been wanting to try that for so long. And then for concealer, I got the e.l.f. 16 Hour Camo Concealer. I already have this, but the color I got was literally so light. So I got the color Medium Sand to match me better. And then I'm going to give my sister the one that's too light for me because it is literally so white. And I really like this concealer, and I feel like it was only like $4. I don't know. I could be wrong, but so this color is definitely going to be a lot better for me, especially since it's summer. But yeah, these, Sun Powder for Face and Body. So it's just this huge bronzer. I feel like this is going to be comparable to the Morphe one. I haven't tried that one. I was going to buy it, but this one was cheaper. And it looks really freaking pretty. So we're going to try this out. And then I've heard Tati talk about this. I think it's Tati. I could be wrong, but I watch all of her videos, so it probably was her. This is the Master Chrome by Maybelline Molten Gold Face Highlighter, and this is definitely like dark. So if you have a lighter skin tone, definitely would go for more of a lighter color, but she said this color is gorgeous, so maybe it'll perform a little bit lighter on my face. And then the last thing that I got today was the Milani Keep It Full Lip Gloss. This is just like a skin color. You guys know I'm into glosses, especially for summer. So this is gonna be really fun. And this is just in the color Champagne. So with drugstore, I feel like a lot of products nowadays are still pretty expensive for it being the drugstore. But I did want to start doing these videos for y'all just because it is still a lot cheaper than high-end. Like, I think I spent like $60 on 6 products, whereas if you go to Ulta or Sephora, you could spend $60 on 1 product. So I still think that's a pretty good price. I feel like you could get a full face at the drugstore for probably $100, which I do not think is bad at all, especially if you're just starting off doing makeup and you just want to try some things out. Now on to the products that I already have. So I'm gonna just go ahead and start, and then you guys will see like the other products that I have. So I'm gonna first start off by moisturizing my face with my favorite moisturizer. This is a Neutrogena what is this, Hydro Boost Gel Cream. I talked about this in my favorites video It is so good and refreshing. I also had this in my skincare video. I'll leave both of those videos below. It is such a good moisturizer. And the brushes that I'm going to be using today are not drugstore. Most of them are going to be Morphe, but they're very affordable as well. I'm going to show you guys a lot of eyeshadows that are affordable and drugstore and all that. But after I do my moisturizer, I'm going to be taking the e.l.f. Putty Primer. I already had this, and I didn't want to spend money on another primer because I know that I like this. So, I'm not sure how much any of this is, but I will be leaving all of the, prices on the screen. I already said that, but just in case you didn't hear me, they should be listed on the screen. I'm not going to be saying the prices of anything because I literally have no clue. And of course, after my freaking skincare video, my skin literally breaks out and it looks horrible in this video. But I'm kind of glad because we can really test that foundation out and see how good it is. So, that is the primer. We're going to go on in with the foundation. I'm praying that this is my color or at least somewhere near because we can always bronze it up. I just put this much, and we're just going to go in. I think it should be good. The smell is pretty strong. I think this is going to be a good color. Oh, I think I forgot to tell you guys what the color even was. Hold on. Let me see if I can find it. I, like, struggled finding it. Where the heck is it? Soft Sand. That's the color I got. They don't have very many colors to choose from. Just a warning for light or dark skin. I'm lucky that I'm like in between, so they had a pretty decent color. The only thing that sucks about like drugstore is you can't really you can't really test the foundations without like opening it, and I don't want to like open ones and then, you know, them not be the right color. That's just gross. Yeah, that's the only thing that stinks about drugstore. I wish they had, like, tester ones, but it's a little light, but we can bronze it up, so I'm fine with it. I'm honestly liking how it's looking so far. It's giving me pretty nice coverage. It is very, very dewy foundation. If you do have oily skin and you don't like dewy foundation, this would probably not be the best option, but I love a dewy skin even with my oily skin, which is probably really weird, but I never go for a matte foundation. I always do a like luminous or natural whatever finish. So now I'm going to take the e.l.f. concealer. Like I said, this is a medium sand, and I'm going to just go under my eyes. And I know already that I like this concealer a lot, so I'm going to just do on my pimples and everything. So the only thing that I don't have that's drugstore is an eyebrow product. I literally just struggle trying to find a good drugstore eyebrow product because I don't know. I just am very picky, and I really just love my brow pomade from Anastasia. So I'm going to probably just do my brows off camera since I didn't find like a drugstore eyebrow little thing. I have a few, but I'm not obsessed with them. So I don't really want to feature them in this video. But so far, I like how my skin's looking. It looks very luminous. But we're obviously gonna bake and everything like that. So the two powders that I have are both the Maybelline Fit Me. I have the pressed and the loose. So I'm gonna go ahead and take the loose powder first. And I'm just gonna set under the eyes, around the nose to start. And like just in my T-zone basically. wait, I really like how this foundation looks. And I'm not really like a foundation girl. Everyone knows, if you've watched me forever, that I'm a CC cream girl. That's my favorite. But I'm liking this so far. Now I'm just going to take the Fit Me powder, and I'm going to take the same brush that I use. This is the Morphe E48, and it's really good for the under eyes. I don't like baking with a sponge, so I just kind of bake a little bit, because I do get literally the worst crease under my eyes ever. Like, it is so bad. And I'm gonna go around my nose a little bit, so like that. So now, while that is baking, I'm going to go ahead and take the L'Oreal bronzer. I do have another bronzer option, but I use this in every one of my videos, so I wanted to do something new. This is the Butter Bronzer from Physicians Formula. I'll go ahead and swatch it to kind of show you guys. You can't really see it. It's right there, but it's a really good bronzer, but we're going to try this one out today. This one has a little bit of a luminosity to it, which I am kind of excited about because I usually just stay with the matte bronzer, but I'm going to take the Morphe M527, and it's just a big fluffy brush. I'm going to dip into that and work it. Ooh, I think I like. I haven't worn makeup on this pimple, and it literally looks horrible. Really pretty. And it's like buildable, you know? They had three different colors as well, so it's not just like one shade. I'm gonna go ahead and go down my nose a little bit. Weren't slick.
What are you talking about?
You was literally right there. Do you like so far? It's white.
Oh. Just the one thing.
It looks bad. Now you have me insecure.
No, I thought it was just the light.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be outside for a second.
Okay. I don't care.
You don't care?
No. Take your time. So yeah, that's the bronzer. So now I'm gonna go ahead and do my eyebrows off camera really quick, and then I will come back and finish the rest of my makeup. Okay, so we have the eyebrows basically done. Don't look at them. They always need to be done, okay? When I film a YouTube video, they always need to be done. So I'm gonna go ahead and move to the eyes, and then we'll finish off with highlight at the end. But I've never found a drugstore eyeshadow primer, so I'm gonna just prime my eyes with some concealer. So I have a lot of palettes to show you guys, but I'm not going to be doing a crazy eye look because I have work tonight, and I just don't want anything too crazy for work. So I'm just going to do something simple, but then swatch a lot of the shades for you guys. So the first two actual drugstore palettes that I have that are pretty good are the CoverGirl ones and the Wet n Wild. So the CoverGirl ones are a lot more chalky. I'll swatch some shades for y'all. The glitters in them are so pretty. The formula is super soft. It's just very powdery. Like, you can see kind of how powdery it is, but the colors themselves are really pretty. They're just so buttery that they're chalky almost. So there's some of the colors. The glitters, these two are gorgeous, and I think that this is a really good palette, especially, like I said, if you're just starting off and you want to get into some color. These like purple tones are really pretty, and you get some more dark ones. I just didn't swatch them. So that is the first drugstore one. I'm not going to be using that in the video though. The next one is this Wet n Wild. They have so many different shades, but I'm going to just, like I said, swatch a few of these colors just to kind of show you guys the formula. So I'm going to do the two transition shades that they have. So they have the two transitions, and then these are all metallics, or shimmers, whatever you want to call it. So this color, look at that. It's like I don't even know what to call it. It is freaking stunning. So look at that. Are you kidding me? These Wet n Wild palettes are incredible. I used to use the, like, Walking on Eggshell one whenever I was, like, 10, and I used to hear, like, every YouTuber talk about Wet n Wild Walking on Eggshell freaking trio. And so Wet n Wild has always had really good formulas for their eyeshadows, but Drugstore has been stepping up their game lately. Like, look at this face. Okay. So this you can only get at Sally's Beauty. I don't know if you have this near you, but freaking Tati talks about this all the time. So this is the collab. This is like their Sally's brand or whatever. So I'm gonna look at that pigment. So I just swatched the first row here, but they're literally, oh my gosh. Look at that. I was to recommend any of these to y'all. If y'all have Sally's, definitely pick up the collab. This is the, I don't know if this is called Best of the Day. I don't know if that's the what the palette's called, but it is so pretty. Like, these colors are gorgeous, and you can create so many different looks. Like, you can do an orangey, you can do a neutral brown, you can add some pink. Like, this shimmer, hello, look at that shimmer. We might just have to use that today. So I would definitely recommend these out of the three I just showed. So these next ones I'm not going to swatch because I feel like I have a lot of videos using these palettes and all of that. But I did just want to mention, if you are into makeup already and you want to get a little bit more high quality than Drugstore, I would definitely check out Morphe. They have really nice eyeshadows, especially the Jaclyn Hill Vault. These are, I want to say, $13 a piece. You get 10 shades. So I have the Armed and Gorgeous, which is this one right here. And then I also have the Bling Boss. So she has four different ones, but these are the two that I have, and they're so beautiful. The glitters are gorgeous. The mattes perform so nicely, and it's really affordable, especially nowadays that Drugstore is so expensive. I feel like you can get Drugstore ones for this much, and the quality is not going to be as good. Also, I tried to pick up the Profusion palettes that a lot of people are talking about on YouTube. And, of course, the Walmart that I go to, they didn't have them. So, that's going to be in a different video where I just test out a few Profusion palettes because they look gorgeous. And one of my favorite YouTubers talks about Profusion all the time and reviews their palettes all the time. And they look gorgeous, and they're literally $10, and they're, like, huge palettes. So, these are really good. Then if you're starting off and you just want a really good neutral palette with a lot of neutrals in it, I would definitely go for this one. This is the 35O. So you have all your warm tone browns, your oranges, your shimmers. This is what I would start off with. I think these big palettes are like $24, which isn't bad at all for how many shadows you're getting. But yeah, this is the one I would recommend if you're wanting a really good neutral palette that has a lot of colors. Or if you are starting off doing other people's makeup, this is also a really good palette. This is what I use on people that I do their makeup for a lot of the time, because usually for weddings and proms, people stick to these warm browns and golds and things like that. So this is a really good palette. But if you're wanting to step out into the color world, but you also want some neutrals, the original Jaclyn Hill palette is also amazing. So you have your colors on the back, and then you have your neutrals, you have your reds, your burgundies, your golds, your pinks, and then down here you have a few pops of color. So this is also a really good palette. I think my first video was using this palette with like the reds and stuff, because I loved this palette and I still love it. I still use it all the time. So yeah, this is a really good one if you're starting off and wanting to get in some color. So that's another good one. So now I want to swatch these two BH Cosmetics eye lights. So me and my sister heard about these through Tati, of course, and my sister actually got these for me. I was at work and she was like, they're $3. What colors do you want? So I got the colors Psych and Fresh. And I'm not going to use these today, but I will be doing a video using these, maybe with the Profusion video or some kind of video because these are absolutely insane. So, like I said, they were $3. They're not huge, but look at this, y'all. So, this is Psych right here. I'm going to go ahead and swatch it. Look at that. It's an eye glitter, whatever you want to call it. It's like the Stila ones, or a lot of people are making these now. But look at that color. It's like a pinky purple with that blue reflect. It is beautiful. And then here is Fresh. It's a more of a yellow with a blue tint to it as well. They are stunning. For $3, like, it's a great deal. And I recommend these, especially if you're a glitter person. I think they had more of neutral shades. My sister got a blue one, and it is stunning. So yeah, those are so beautiful. $3, link below, go buy you some. I don't know if they're $3 anymore, if that was the sale or what, but pretty sure they're $3. Now that we have went over all the palettes, I'm gonna go ahead and do the eyes. So I'm gonna first start off with this shade. They don't have color names, but it's just like a neutral transition. That it does have a little kickback, but come on, that color payoff was stunning. So I'm probably just going to do like this color and a little bit of a darker brown in the corner, and then pop that glitter on the inside because it is stunning. I did get my eyelashes redone. I don't know if I have done a video since I've got them redone. I'm so glad I did. I just hope my real eyelashes aren't completely screwed, which they probably are, but it's fine. So here is that. I'm gonna just kind of keep darkening that a little bit because these are so buildable and they blend perfect. And that's another thing, especially if you're just starting off wanting to get into makeup, you need something that's gonna like basically blend itself out, because like when I first started, I had no clue how to blend eyeshadow, and the eyeshadows I got did not help that at all. So next thing I'm gonna take is just this darker brown, and I'm barely gonna dip into it. I just want to kind of define that crease just a little bit, kind of deepen it just some, not a whole ton. Something slight. I never do dark eyes anymore. Literally all of my looks are like so light and airy. So just like that, just a little something. So freaking pretty. Tati talks about their mascara all the time as well. My sister has it. I'm gonna ask her if she likes it, because Tati says it's the best mascara she's ever used, like including drugstore and everything. So, might be the tea. So, I'm going to go back in with a different brush and go back in that light shade and just kind of darken it up some and make sure those two colors are blended together really nicely. See, I didn't do much, just something. To spice up my look. Okay. Now, for starters, if you need a brush, go to Ulta. If you have an Ulta near you. Let me see which brush I want to recommend. Hold on. Gotta find it. Right here. Okay. The M441 by Morphe. This is a must. You need this in your makeup. I'm going to darken my crease some more with that darker brown because I feel like it. My eyelashes are so big this time. I love them, but I'm like, can you get out of my way a little bit? And then the second brush that you need is the M431. This pencil brush, I'm going to dip in to this color. I'm not going to wet it. I'm just going to go in and see what the payoff is. And I'm gonna go in that inner corner. Wow. That is so pretty. So, it's a little bit darker than I wanted. So, I'm going to go in with a different palette. With a lighter color. And just lighten it up some. Because it's a little bit darker. This would be really pretty on, like, the lid. But, let's see here what I can find. I'm going to take this white color. Because that'll be really good to blend in with that. And I'm just going to put that in there as well. There we go. So it's still a champagne, but it's like a white. There we go. Okay. Same. Okay. There we go. So this is all I'm going to do for the eyes. Now back for the face. I'm going to take my Jeffree Star X Morphe brush. And I'm going to dip in to the Master Chrome by Maybelline. We're going to test this because Tati said it was amazing, so we're going to find out if it actually is. So I'm going to first do it on my nose to see. Oh, wow. She was right. Look at that. And I didn't even wet my face or my brush or anything. It's a very subtle but buildable color. So yeah, definitely if you have lighter skin, I would go for a little bit of a lighter color, but these highlighters in general are literally stunning. Like, look at that. And I'm gonna go on my forehead a little bit. So stunning. To top it off, I'm going to just go ahead and put some chapstick on. Milani lip gloss. If I can get it open. It's just a neutral gloss. We all know that's my favorite. But should I use a lip liner? I think I'm going to. I don't have a drugstore one, but this is not necessary. I'm just, like, seeing if it looks good. So. Dark lip liner with. Oh, yes. I love this gloss. It's minty. I feel like it's gonna be, like, a. So here's the look that I have for you guys. So, like I said, all these products will be linked below. I love this palette. I've, like, kind of briefly swatched it before, but I've never used it. This is my first time using it, and I'm obsessed. I would definitely recommend this out of all the ones that I recommended if you're looking for something, like, on the cheaper side. This is the way to go. I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any of my videos, and turn on my post notifications so you definitely don't miss my videos and you get notified every time I upload. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in my next one. Peace.